Hello, it's Kevin Bacon again. What a difference a day makes. Holy cow. We got somewhere between half and three-quarter inch rain last night. There hasn't been any sun today. It's actually very cool out here in the mid-60s. Way out of the ordinary for this time of year. I'm showing you the irises. They have really, really popped into bloom. We took a look at the potatoes a couple of days ago. And they were just little nubbins. But now, that little one over there that I had to dig out of the grass is almost as tall as the grass. And I have a row of them here, nine in a row in the one row. I think there were actually 10 in there. There's an itty bitty one right there. They're coming up nicely. I did notice on the video that these look a little on the yellow side. They're not. They're a really nice green, so the camera doesn't do justice to the color. But they really, really sprouted up since we got that rain on top of them. Hopefully a bunch more are coming up. I see sprouts all over the place. Anyway, that's part of what I came up here for today. This little critter down here we talked about. Horse nettle. I want to talk about horse nettle real quickly again. Susan Rogers said where they are, they call it pigweed. Down here, they don't call it pigweed. We're going to talk about pigweed here in just a second. Once again, this plant is poisonous. It is also called wild tomato. It has these yellow miniature cherry tomato looking things on it. It is indeed poisonous. But today, I have come out here with my colander because we're going to get some lunch. So, what are we going to eat today? Well, indeed, we are going to eat pigweed. Pigweed? There it is. Lamb's quarter, amaranth, quinoa. All the same critter. Now the trick is to pick it by snapping it off where it snaps off very nicely and not to go too deep on it. Now I noticed some in here with this giant ragweed. Is he right there? There's a beautiful piece. And I'm going to pick enough of this because I have a whole front yard full of it here. And we're going to eat it. While I'm walking around here picking this stuff, I want to talk about it a little bit. In some circles, it's called wild spinach. And it, like spinach and some other greens, contains oxalic acid. It has a fairly large amount of oxalic acid. So the cautions are, if you are prone to kidney stones and whatnot, you probably ought not to eat this plant raw. But if you cook it, and especially if you cook it with perhaps a tiny little bit of baking soda or something like that, you can neutralize the oxalic acid, which should neutralize pretty much anyway in the cooking process. You know, I have, I'm looking up here and I think I have some sunflowers popped up here. Just out of the middle of nowhere, and I think that they're just seeds that my rabbits didn't eat. It's fine, I'll let them go. I like sunflowers. Okay. See, I'm getting a pot full here. So, if oxalic acid is a problem, then do a little research on how to neutralize the oxalic acid. It is indeed just an acid, so if you treat it such, you can. If you want to boil the water and pour all the water off and start over again, you can do that. But I've eaten, oh goodness sakes, large quantities of this stuff. It has never given me any problem myself. Now, I kind of walked up here. There's another horse nettle. Now, here's a big one. These things are horrible, and they're covered with these tiny, tiny little thorns. So you got to be careful when you mess with them because they will hurt you. And of course the thorns tend in my experience, to break off when you step on them or whatever. So then you've got an extremely painful little area. Anyway, I steer clear of the little thing. We have lots of them. They seem to like the better soil, I guess. Anyway, let's walk around here into the yard where my largest area of these things is. Get a big pot of these and go in and cook them. I'm going to get something else while I'm out here. You know, if you watch my videos, that I have garlic. So I'm going to get some of this garlic over here. Now, here's another critter right here, and I have talked about this in the past. This is called greenbrier, and I'm told that the leaves of the greenbrier plant are edible, and if you collect them when they're young like this, they're tender and delicious. Now, I'm going to do a little more research before I dig into that. I haven't been eating that for years and years, but I have been eating lamb's quarter. So here we go. I have a whole big area here where I can harvest a large amount of lamb's quarter. There are plantain right there, the broadleaf plantain. There's one right here at my feet. They're also edible. I find them to be a bit on the bitter side for me. Some people do eat them. I'm going to get some of this. I'm going to walk over here to my garlic, though. I see it clear from here. I'm going to grab a handful of garlic, and I'm going to grab a handful of the flat-leafed garlic right here. Just snatch a good handful of that. Oh, that smells good. Make sure you get what you know you're getting. And then right down in here and amongst it, I also have some of the round, more onion-looking garlic. And I'm going to grab some of that. It has a little bit milder flavor than the broad-leafed garlic, if I can find it here. So I'll get all this together, we'll get inside, we'll put it in a pot, and we'll cook it up. One thing I want to caution you about when you're gathering wild greens is to make sure that you sort your greens carefully and make sure that indeed what you got was what you were after before you put it in the pan. Sometimes I find that I end up with a piece of clover like this here, and I really don't want that in there, but it could just as well have been something else that we don't want. Now, the clover wouldn't hurt me, but there are other plants out there that might. So, sort your gathering carefully, and also, you know, you got to look for bugs and other things that you didn't notice while you were out doing your harvesting. So I give them a good look over. You want to make sure there's no dirt or anything on them. I've already washed them. We throw them in the pan. Of course, any spots that are bad on the leaves, just like you would any other greens. And I'll tell you something. When you cook these down, you start out with quite a pile, and they cook away to a much smaller amount. So if you're going to prepare these, you want to make sure that you gather a bunch. Otherwise, you're not going to have enough. All right. Okay, I got my pot of lamb's quarter there. And now I'm going to add my garlic. And I just wanted to show you this garlic. I'm going to cut this up just like I would green onions from a store. I'm going to chop the bulbs up and throw them in there. And then I'm going to chop up some of the green leaf. Some of the leaves will be a little bit on the tough side, so you want to watch out for the older leaves, but the younger leaves are tender. If you grab that first leaf on the outside and pull it back down, it'll skin that bulb, and then all you have to do is cut off the little roots there on the bottom and just chop your way up the top. They are tasty. This is a little bit milder garlic than you might get in a store. I mean, if you don't like garlic, obviously don't put it in your greens, but I'm going to put all four of these in that pot. you're looking to me to be fast like a chef, yeah, you're looking at the wrong guy. These old arthritic hands are just not made for that kind of stuff anymore. And I use a cleaver because the cleaver gets me way up in the air here where I don't have to worry about banging my knuckles on the stove or the cutting board. And I'm going to say that's probably going to be enough for us there today. So probably somewhere in the neighborhood of a cup or 3/4 of a cup of garlic in my greens. That ought to make it real good. Now let's bring that forward. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add some water to the bottom. I'm going to add about a third pan of water. I'm going to put in a little dash of vinegar because I like vinegar in my herbs. And beyond that, a little salt and a little pepper. And that's it. That's all that goes in my greens. Now, how long do you have to cook it? Well, you have to cook it until the greens are tender, and they're going to get real dark green. So I'll get that started and we'll get a look. Okay, just for comparison, we're going to start out with this pan about 3/4 of the way full. We'll see how much we got when we're done boiling it. I want to bring the pan up to a boil, then I want to turn it down so it just lightly boils. I will start that hot and we'll cool it down. Turn the temperature of the burner down when the water starts to boil. We want to cover the pan so the steam from down below comes up to your greens. All right, we got a boil going on here. Now I'm just going to stir this around a little bit to get my salt and pepper down into the, and spill a little on the stove. That's important. I'm using my trusty rice paddle. I bought these at a Chinese grocer about a year ago. I really like them. You want to get the ones that are flexible, not the hard plastic ones. I got some of the hard plastic ones, but they break. And there you see, it's only boiled just that short little period of time, and half of it volume has dropped. We'll turn this down and we'll steam it until it's tender, and you see the dark color that's coming? That's what we want. Cover her up. I give it a few minutes. I come back and I check it. When we get there, we'll get another look. All right, we've been boiling now for about 4 minutes, and you can see that the greens have gotten a nice olive color. They're getting closer. It doesn't take a long time. Grab a fork here. Just reach in here with a fork and grab one of these and get an idea how tender they are. It's edible, but I'm going to give it about another 4 minutes. All right, we give it another 4 minutes. Turn it off. Here's what you're looking at. Smells wonderful. Reminds me a little bit of asparagus, but not a lot. Now, here's another trick. We're going to serve this with tongs and let the juice fall off the bottom. And the reason we want to do that, if you dip to the bottom of the pan, you may find that there's a little bit of sand on the bottom of the pan from leaves that kept it and you didn't see it. So I'm going to eat the greens. And I've got here a stuffed pepper that I made the other day, half of one with a little chili and a little red enchilada sauce. And that's my lunch right there. So let's see how this stuff tastes. Marvelous. Marvelous. Flavor. Very, very similar to spinach. Very mild. Not bitter like a lot of other greens. Not nearly as strong as collard greens or mustard greens. Very, very tasty. Very, very tasty. So, get out there, find you some. Make sure you know what you're getting. Make sure you don't get some other stuff mixed in there that doesn't belong. And boil you up a little pot. I think you'll enjoy it. Come bake it. Bye for now.